Running a database using a Docker run command can get complex with all of the parameters you need to remember. But there is a simpler way, and I'll show you how. We're going to use a Docker compose file. This means we don't need to remember all of our parameters, and we can store these files in Git as source code. Step one is to create a new file. Save this with the name docker-compose.yml. You can add this anywhere you want on your computer, but for this example, I've saved it in a folder called Docker Test inside the Documents folder. This YML or YAML file, as it's often called, follows a certain format and syntax. We define a range of attributes and values, with some attributes nested under others. We start with the word services, then a colon. On a new line, we add two spaces, then the word DB. On the next line, we indent another two spaces. Here is where we specify all of the attributes we want for our new container. We specify a container name, which is our name for the container on our computer. I'll demo this using the Postgres database, so I'll give it a name of pg_container. On the next line, we have the image attribute. This is the name of the Docker image to use for the container and comes from the Docker Hub registry by default. I'll enter the name Postgres. We can specify the versions here by using a colon and a number, but for now, we'll just use this default one. Then we have environment, which is where we specify the environment variables. Under the environment attribute, we add some attributes that are specific to the Postgres image. For this example, we need to add the Postgres user and Postgres password. These will be created within the new Docker container. I'll specify Postgres test for both, but you could specify whatever you like. Then on a new line, we add the word ports. This is indented one level less, so it's on the same level as environment, not within it. On the line after ports, we specify the ports to use for this container. We start with a dash, then enclose the port number of 5432 within it, then a colon, then 5432. The first number is the port to use from your computer to access the container, and the second number is used by the Postgres database to expose to your computer. Most of the time, they will be the same. On your computer, you'll probably use the same numbers as well. However, I've already got Postgres installed, which is using port 5432, so I'll have to use a different one. I'll change this first number to 5433, which means my computer can use 5433 to access this Postgres database in the container. The second number is unchanged. Our file is now ready, so save it. If you want an easy way to remember a bunch of the Docker commands for working with databases, then you'll love the Docker cheat sheet I created. Get your copy at the link in the description. Next, we go to the terminal or command prompt. Change to the directory that your Docker compose file is saved in. For me, it's within the Documents folder, then Docker Test. Now let's run the container. All we need to do is write docker compose up. This command will look for a file named docker-compose.yml and read the attributes in the file. The word up means start the container. We run this and Docker will download the image in the file if it does not exist. In this case, it's the Postgres image. Once the download is done, the container is started. When it's running, you'll see a line here that says something like, "Database is ready to accept connections." You'll also see this little black square. This is because the terminal session is being used to run the Docker command. We didn't run it in the background or detached mode, but we could have. Our container should be running. We can check this by opening a new tab in terminal or command prompt, then running docker ps. We can see the container listed here that we created, called pg_container. So our container is running. We can now connect to it and work with it as if we had used the docker run command. Let's connect to this database using the psql tool. To do this, enter the psql command, specify the user as Postgres test. We then specify the host as localhost, which is the default. Press enter and you're prompted for the password. I'll enter Postgres test, as that was the password from the Docker compose file. Press enter again and the PSQL prompt is shown. We're now connected to the database. I get an error because of an incorrect password. This is because PSQL is trying to connect to my other Postgres database on port 5432 and not port 5433 that I just set up. So I change this command to use port 5433 and run it again. I enter the password and it is successful. We can exit PSQL by typing /q, then pressing enter. If you want to stop the container, you can run docker compose down. This will shut down the container. You can run docker ps again with the a parameter to show all containers to see that it is no longer running. What if we have several databases we want to use? For example, you want to have another Docker container for another vendor such as MySQL or a different version of Postgres. Well, we can create different YAML files for each database we may want to use. Then we can use a variation of the docker compose command to start them. Let's create another YAML file for a MySQL database. I'll call the file dbmysql.yml. It doesn't need to be called docker compose or anything, as we can specify the file name when we run the command. We can add the attributes that are required for this container. For MySQL, they are similar to Postgres, but the password attribute is different, and we specify the database name here. The ports are also 3306. We can save this file. To start a new Docker container with our MySQL file we just created, we go back to the terminal. I'll stop my earlier Postgres container by pressing Ctrl-C, and I am returned to the terminal prompt. We use the docker compose command. We add the -f attribute, which means the file name we want to use. We specify db-mysql.yml, which is the file we created. Then we have the word up. Press enter and this is run. After a moment, the container is running, just like the Postgres container. We can also do this with different versions of databases, if you want to test your application on different versions or test an upgrade. It's also possible to use an image that is not on the Docker Hub by specifying the full path to the image in the image attribute. Docker by default does not save data in between sessions, but you can configure it to do so. You'll want to watch this video next to learn about this feature and how to set it up. Thanks for watching.